Hello, welcome once again to NCRT's live phone in program. And in this English session, you're watching us on PME Vidya channel number 10. Well, for all the class 10 students, we're going to discuss the poem. Poem titled Animals, written by Walt Whitman. Well, we are going to talk about animals for sure. So if you are an animal lover, if you care about animals, you have pets. So a lot of you must be having pets. Please stay with us and keep on asking if you have any doubts. I'm sure you are going to love this poem and its explanation as well. So we'll begin in a short while, but just let me just tell you that if you have questions, NCERT official, that's our YouTube channel, watch this session over there, and yes, share your questions in the chat box as well. CIET.KishoreManch@gmail.com, that's the email address. You can write your questions and share it through email also. So let's meet our expert. We have with us Professor Meghanathan. Welcome, sir.
Hello learners. Hello Tanvi, how are
you?
Hello
sir, I'm great.
The learners, we are meeting after a long time, class 10.
Absolutely. So, sir is from Department of Education and Languages, NCERT, New Delhi. So, without wasting any more time, let's begin with this discussion. So, poem, this is the poem, Animals.
Animals. What and you said what Whitman.
Yes.
So, it's a famous, celebrated American poet who lived in 19th century. Generally, I won't talk about the poet, but today we'll talk a bit about him to understand how the poet belonged to romantic period, like Wordsworth and all. But we'll come to it later. Now, you said when you introduced the poem, you said that if you are animal lover, if you have pet, it's not only for those who love animals and who have pets, but in general about animals.
Okay.
That's what. So let me begin with a question. If you see the slide there, what is special about animals? I've kept it blank. Learners, think about it. It's not the animal which you have as a pet. You see many animals, cows, calves, buffaloes, donkeys, horses, of course your pet animals too. What comes to your mind when you see an animal?
A lot of things. Well, we say about dogs that they are trustworthy, but apart from that, in general, animals, they're harmless. Unless we hurt them, they never hurt us.
And they live their life on their own.
Yes.
And do we humans live our life on our own?
No, we're dependent.
that's a question. We'll come to that later. So that's what. Let us read the poem once.
Sure.
So learners, when you take up your poem to read, to understand, let's read. I'm going to read for you learners first. Then look at the lines there. Let's read.
Sure.
Then try to understand. I think I could turn and live with animals. They are so placid and self-contained. I stand and look at them long and long. They do not sweat and whine about their condition. They do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sins. They do not make me sick discussing about their duty to God. No one is dissatisfied and not one is demented with the many of owning things. Not one kneels to another, not to his kind that lived thousands of years ago. Not one is respectable or unhappy over the whole earth. So they show their relationship to me and I accept them. They bring me tokens of myself. They evince them plainly in their possession. I wonder where they get there those tokens. Did I pass that way huge times ago or negligently drop them? That's what the poet says. A simple line, you need not only three or four words which children may not know the direct meaning, but they are very clear about it. Look at it. This is the poet who was born 200 years ago.
Yeah.
Then who lived through the racial, discriminatory America. And then America was transforming into whatever democracy today, I don't know whether I should say democracy, whatever the country today, as a from a normal ordinary country into a superpower, economically vibrant country. Abraham Lincoln liberates the blacks and he was shot dead. Walt Whitman was a romantic poet who looks at the changes which take place all through the American life, then looks at it how humans, civilization has done to themselves all wrong, and how the other species on earth, that is animals, vegetation, they have really lot more to tell us. This is what, it's not just didactic or moralizing, in order to ask people of people to, not only Americans, the whole world, humanity, to introspect and live how you are unable to live even a life which animals tell you to live. Now look at it. I'm going to ask you to read again for the learners, then we will move on to the activity. Come
sure.
on.
Animals by Walt Whitman. I think I could turn and live with animals. They are so placid and self-contained. I stand and look at them long and long. They do not sweat and whine about their condition. They do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sins. They do not make me sick discussing their duty to God. Not one is dissatisfied, not one is demanded with the mania of owning things. Not one kneels to another, nor to his kind that lived thousands of years ago. Not one is respectable or unhappy over the whole earth. So they show their relations to me, and I accept them. They bring me tokens of myself. They evince them plainly in their possession. I wonder where they get those tokens. Did I pass that way huge times ago, or negligently drop them?
Fine. The poet has many things to regret, and not individually, for the humanity. So let's look at it. The first few lines. I think I could turn and live with animals. They are so placid and contained. Look at it. Learners, you can see animals, they eat whatever they want to eat. They don't overeat. They are satisfied. If they find a shelter, they live. And that's what, I should become an animal. He says humans should better turn out to be animals and live better life than what you are. Look at them. I stand and look at them long and long. You must have noticed the birds. For some time you stop and stand. Almost every one of us have done.
Yeah.
And the way when you enter the house, our pet dog or cat comes and gives you something which you can't explain.
Yeah.
And what it is, but you understand. That's what, I stand and look at them. They do not sweat or whine about their condition.
Yeah.
So some of us live better condition. Rich, living in palatial houses, some don't have houses, but both the category of people, we complain, we groan. Look at the words used. They do not sweat or whine about their condition. Almost every one of us, you may be a president or you may be a man every day looking for some food with your work, but that's what the poet uses, the word sweat and whine. Look at the lines there. They do not sweat and whine about their condition. No animal complains, I am poor, I am rich, I am with a rich master, poor master. So look at that. They do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sins. Sometimes we do sins, means we do commit great blunders, and go alone, sit in the night and cry. Animals don't do.
Yeah.
And if they cry, they cry in open. Look at next one. They do not make me sick discussing their duty to God. Many people say, I have not taken care of my parents, I have not done two good things to my children, because I have failed in my duty as a parent, as I have failed in a duty as a son. So they say, by failing duty to themselves, their people, they think that they have failed in duty to God.
Right.
So look at it. So no animal does that. It lives as an animal. No one is dissatisfied, not one is demented of many of owning things. For me, this is the most important line, pertinent line. Look at it. So, see, people are owning things and they still feel, I should own more, I should possess more.
Yeah.
Look at the word. No animal is dissatisfied that he has a house or he doesn't have a house, she has a house. No one is demented about the mania of owning things. Humans alone have the mania, that a kind of disease. Mania means over obsession with possessing property, money, things.
Yeah.
So even the richest of the rich wanting to make more money, and the poorest of the poor also wanting to make money. So basically humans want to have more and more things in their possession. And look at it. Next thing, it's exercising power. No one kneels to another, nor to his kind that lived thousands of years ago. So only humans, for power, for favor, we touch others' feet, kneel down. So he is a powerful man, so we do that. Then animals never do that, but not only that, they don't even follow what thousands of years their ancestral animal followed, but we follow it as a heritage. Okay, this is slightly liberating for young people, so don't kneel down before power. So we should actually learn that, but animals don't do that. If it is ferocious, if it is angry, it will attack you.
Yeah.
If it is passionate about you, loving, it will show it. But do humans do that? You do not know. We don't do actually. Look at the next line. Will you read? No one is
respectable or unhappy over the whole earth.
Yes. But what about humans? Either we are very happy about earth or we are unhappy. Suppose today, let me take the example. If I lose the job today, I will be completely unhappy.
Right.
And I am happy. I have a job, this thing, I am a teacher, what else and what not. This is the possessions which make me happy. But animals never. Even if you give them as much as food, they may be satisfied. They will not show that I am very happy and I am satisfied. Completely unsatisfied. Look at it. Next one. So they show their relations to me, but look at it, we show our mania to possess things. Learners, look at it, animals show their relationship, we also show our relationship, but our relationships are what? Based on some conditions. He is my mother, father, only with my relations, but their relations is different. They show love and affection to the other species and I accept them because they show, what's it? By unbiased love, unperturbed love, objective love, so I accept them. They bring me tokens of myself. Look at that is the one of the what's it, hallmark of this poem, sentences. They bring me tokens of myself. So sometimes, you know, when the people, inspirers and gurus speak to us, be yourself. Then even I think great scriptures like Bible, Gita and Quran, they say be yourself. So they bring to me tokens of myself. So what are the tokens? Be yourself. And they envies them plainly in their possession. So they possess their being themselves. But whereas, do we do that? We change colors, we have identity, we belong to languages, we belong to nations, we belong to religions. But animals, one category, animals. Look at it. I wonder where they get those tokens. I do not know. They can't think. They don't have the senses we have. But the sixth sense of rationalism. But I wonder whether they get those tokens, from where they get. But they gave me what I did. Look at the, read the last sentence please.
So did I pass that way huge times ago and negligently drop them?
That's what, you know, you can connect it with the evolution of human. So we also were once like animals, not completely evolved as humans today. But we had the tokens with ourselves. We never distinguished that we are Americans, we are Aryans, we are Dravidians, where we are Mongoloids, we are Chinese. But today, I lost those myself position as humanity, as an animal. Today, I am divided by many, many things.
Right.
So that's what. Now, look at the poet again. Look at the thinking of the man. He wrote the poem Leaves of Grass, in which song of myself.
Okay.
Learners, you need to know one thing, because this was the time Romanticism, first French Revolution, American Revolution, then common man became the hero of the country, not the king's rulers. So he wrote a poem, Leaves of Grass. Nobody bothers about leaves of grass. Is it? Grass is everywhere, so it's most common thing. But he wrote a poem on that, a series, a long narrative, in which one of them is Song of Myself. Nobody in those days sang about common man. He wrote it, in which he says the humanity as a race has completely forgotten itself, that you are a humanity rather than humans with all whims and fancies, likes and dislikes. Okay, now look at it. I'm going to ask you, Tanvif, on behalf of the learners. The poet has many things to say about what animals do. So I'm going to ask you, and let's take up what animals do, then humans will compare in order to understand the poem. You may read out the lines and tell me, or let me read out, you may talk about it.
Sure.
I think we have another 10 minutes with us, most likely.
Right,
okay.
More than that.
I think I could turn and live with animals. They are so placid and self-contained. What do animals do?
They are placid and they are self-contained.
Okay, what animals do? I'm writing here, learners, you may look at it. They are self-contained. I'm going to write it. Sorry for my handwriting. They are self-contained. Okay? They are satisfied. Okay. Now, number two. They do not sweat and whine about their conditions. Whine is groaning, making noises. Oh, Allah will love them.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So?
They do not whine.
Whine means they do not, I am writing, groan about their condition.
Okay.
So, I have studied well, I have not got a good job, I could have been, so they don't groan about their condition. Okay. Then, third one.
Then they do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sins, which is like they don't complain.
They don't complain. Okay. Then
they do not make me sick discussing their duty to God, which means they are not religious or they have no faith in, you know.
How to put it? That's what learners look at. When a poet writes, he puts small words into loaded with many things. They said it's not about faith. They don't complain about whatever they don't regret about whatever they have done.
Yeah.
Why? Because they do what they actually instinctively as animals. But we humans, because we have the senses,
right?
So we regret, and there is rule of law and order. Rule of law is never for animals. It's for humans.
True.
So that also makes us human. So what to do?
They do not make me sick discussing their duty to God.
Let's go back to the faith thing. Learners, this is 19th century. Charles Darwin wrote The Evolution of a Human. People started questioning God. He says that in those days, religious belief was so much, it was actually affecting human life.
Yeah.
So they are, in a way, let us write, not regretting about whatever they have committed.
The neutral, they don't have any opinions.
Okay, that's what. Very good. You give the word, they are neutral. Then let's go to the next one.
They are satisfied, they're not dissatisfied, so they're satisfied.
They're satisfied about whatever they are.
Yeah. Whatever they own, whatever they don't own.
Yeah. They are satisfied with whatever, they are not materialistic.
They aren't.
They are not materialistic. Fine.
They don't kneel to another, not to the kind that lived thousands of years ago, as in...
they don't submit to others.
They don't.
So, not submitting to others is one big thing, learners. You may be what's that, swayed away or threatened by many, many things, powerful people. But if you are right, stand by that. That's what Indian Constitution gives you provision to, means
right.
Exercise your duty. Then
they are happy.
They are happy. Most important thing. I don't know. Let's go around. Learners, you go around in your neighborhood. Ask people, are you happy? Simple exercise. From your father to grandfather to your sister, brother. And particularly this time, many will not say, I am happy. Okay.
And to yourself as well.
Yeah. At last, you sit back and ask yourself. Great thing. Yeah. Then?
So they show their relations to me and I accept them.
Okay. Relationship.
Relationships.
So, today, how are the relationship?
They're not biased to any relationship. They give their 100% to whosoever their master is.
Yeah. But, what about humans?
They have priorities, they have options. They choose.
Yeah, well, that's what. Learners, this is how the poet has organized the ideas. Look at it, very simple. Only if I look at it, wine and dementing. These are the two words which a normal reader, someone who has studied English for 4 or 5 years, would not understand. So, with a simple poem, he tells a big message. Learners, this is a time for introspection. Actually, the poet actually introspects. There is something called introspection. Every day you spend 5 to 10 minutes, learners, introspect. What have I done today? Have I done anything, everything fine? If I have done everything fine, how can I benefit from that to me as well as others? And the second thing, how can I, if I have done something wrong, if I have hurt somebody unnecessarily, I am not saying that submit to everybody, be polite, everybody can't be Mahatma. Even Mahatma Gandhi used to get angry, but he would show it in a different manner. So, there are ways and means you deal with people, your work and things. Come on, I am going to ask you to read again That's the final reading with some emotions. Come on, learners, look at the poem again. It's with you. We are reading the third time with some purpose, learners. When you go back also, you read 2-3 times. Please, go ahead.
Okay. I think I could turn and live with animals. They are so placid and self-contained. I stand and look at them long and long. They do not sweat and whine about their condition. They do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sins. They do not make me sick discussing their duty to God. Not one is dissatisfied. Not one is demented with the mania of owning things. Not one kneels to another, nor to his kind that lived thousands of years ago. Not one is respectable or unhappy over the whole earth. So they show their relations to me and I accept them. They bring me tokens of myself. They evince them plainly in their possession. I wonder where they get those tokens. Did I pass that way huge times ago and negligently drop them?
Fine. All right. That's a good reading. Learners, we have read three times to you. In order to understand your poem, you have to decode the poem by reading, rereading. And poetry is a language embedded, loaded, imported with a lot of messages,
yeah.
And the individual words have more than one meaning.
Mm.
So, Tanvi, could I ask you something?
Yes.
We can divide the poem into three stages. Mm. One is the poet says about they are self-contained.
Right.
Then what they do not do.
Mm.
So let me ask you a question, learners, for you also. Why does the poet is saying about what they do not do? That means what? These are the things the humans do.
Yeah.
That's what. So look at the contrast there. He should have said, we have reversed it into from negative to positive. That is, they are not dissatisfied. We said, okay, they are satisfied. So learners, if you remove that not, and instead of animals, you say humans, that all applicable to us. It's very interesting. So let's look at some. That's what we have. Few more time. Let's look at the camera here. Let's look at the camera here. I'm going to ask you some questions.
Okay.
On behalf of the learners, you will be answering. Why does the poet want to live with animals?
Because they are self-contained and placid.
And not only that, first one, the whole thing, after having understood the whole...
Yeah, all the conditions actually go with this answer.
Okay. Does the poet think that the animals are happy?
Yes.
Then do you think that the animals know that they are happy? I am asking a reverse question.
Yeah. I think they are, or maybe not.
Because they don't...
They are satisfied with whatever the condition is.
Fine. So, in a way... What Whitman is questioning the very thing of the so-called rationalistic thinking we have, then which makes us humans,
yeah.
is questioning. You feel that you can distinguish between good, bad, right or wrong, you have rule of law, governments, but are you really happy?
That's a big question.
So that's what the animals may not know that they are happy, but they are happy.
Yeah.
Okay. What does the poet mean to say, no one kneels to another?
Like they don't submit.
And no, learners, we know that we are living in the world of submissions. We see the majority, we will go with that.
Yeah.
We will not decide whether it is right or wrong, who is wronged and who is benefiting. But we simply accept it. It's actually kneeling down to the authority.
Yeah.
So, poet says that animals don't kneel down.
Even
that's what hunting, you know, if they want to escape, they can submit to the hunter,
yeah.
But they don't do. So then look at the next one. No one is respectable or unhappy over the whole earth. I think we have 5 minutes more.
Yeah.
Fine. Yeah. No one is respectable or unhappy over the whole earth.
Right.
So what does, why?
Again, and they are happy, they are fine in whatever they do. So they don't complain about the whole earth, as in if there are more plants or
okay,
more humans.
It, yeah, thank you. I'm going to put it, no one is, look at the lines here, no one is respectable or unhappy over the earth. Mm. So he said, no one is unhappy, I understand. Mm. Why didn't he use happy? Instead, he has used respectable. Learners, think about it. He should have easily said, no one is happy or unhappy about the earth.
Maybe respectable because of the social conditions human have. Mm. Like, you have to dress up in a certain way, or do you have to behave in a certain way in front of certain people. There's class, there's levels.
Yes.
So in animals, they don't do that.
So no one feels that I am respectable or disrespectful.
Or inferior or superior.
There's no class in animals.
Yeah.
They are species. They are dogs, cows, calves, whatever the species. But they are simply animals.
Right.
So that's one. That's one. I think we have to stop it here.
Yeah. We've got 2 minutes left.
Okay. Then now let's tell the learners, please read the poem.
Absolutely.
2-3 times. Write your ideas about the poet describes about animals. Mm. So, and your own feeling about animals. And if possible, learners, write a poem on how animals behave, which makes us feel fine. Any animal, not necessarily pet animal.
Mm.
You must, every day I am watching a cow roaming around outside this campus, but it has its own routine, it has its own serenity, peace. I also see that rare species Nilgiri here.
Mm.
They come, they walk like giants.
Yeah.
They threaten me, but at the same time there is some aesthetics in them.
Mm.
So, do we actually exercise that?
Mm.
All right. Learners, so stop it. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. There's a lot for humans to learn from animals, actually.
Great. That's the one message of the poem.
Absolutely. Thank you, sir. Thank you to the students, to the viewers. See, this was one interesting poem. And like I said, if you are animal lovers, you'll be able to relate to this poem a lot more than other people.
True, true.
And I hope you had fun. You found this poem, this explanation to be equally interesting just the way I did. So keep on sending your questions, your compliments. They're all more than welcome. So stay with us. Don't go anywhere. We're coming back with another special program of ours, which is webinar on ICT tool. Which ICT tool will be discussed in this particular session? For that, you have to stay with us. Don't go anywhere. We're coming back after a short break. Thank you once again. Stay happy and stay healthy.